level. Her first 10 in Olympic history showed us perfection was possible.
Another handstand. Look at that. Right to the handstand. Gorgeous routine. Beautiful on the 12 level.
And it is.
A perfect 10.
A strong, almost unstoppable competitive machine.
While others made mistakes, Nadia made none. In 20 years, no one has had such an impact on the sport of gymnastics. She came to us from a mysterious country ruled by the infamous dictator Nicolae Ceaușescu, a ruler who shamelessly used Nadia's fame and made her his prisoner.
I was afraid. Everybody's terrorized. You live in a communist system. You're terrorized.
Her flight for freedom began in a Bucharest train station 5 years ago.
I don't know how am I going to cross the border. I had no idea. I was just going like this, blind, you know?
She risked her life and left everything behind.
What do you think would have happened to you if you got caught?
I don't want to think about it.
She has found safety and a new life in the United States. Now Nadia returns to Romania. Will her countrymen welcome her or resent her? And what has become of those she left behind? Today, her unforgettable journey home.
World of sports, we came to know her affectionately as Nadia. She would change the face of gymnastics and become one of the most remarkable athletes in history. Today, Nadia Comaneci tells her story of a life that wasn't always as it appeared. And she takes us back on a journey to the nation she once fled. Here's Donna De Verona.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Your car on flight 340 to Mishra and Bucharest is now ready for boarding.
It was a journey filled with anticipation. After 5 long years, legendary gymnast Nadia Comaneci was going home to Romania, the country she fled in November of 1989, weeks before the communist regime was overthrown by a bloody revolution. Now Nadia was going back, but many questions remained unanswered. Would she be forgiven? Would she be forgotten? It would be the most daunting voyage of her life. ABC Sports was there when Nadia first took the gymnastics world by surprise.
The big story here is, can a 13-year-old from Romania, Nadia Comaneci, take on and defeat the reigning all-around champion since 1970, Ludmila Tereshkova of the Soviet Union? It's going to be quite an afternoon.
On that day, almost 20 years ago, Nadia did not hesitate to rise to the challenge.
Watch this first tumbling run, how high she gets on it.
Wow!
Unbelievable. She is incredible. To see how strong she is and how hard she lands.
Woo! What was that?
And a new dismount. First time.
And listen to the crowd. They just explode here.
That 4-inch wide beam looks like a sidewalk the way she works it.
A double twist. Unbelievable.
Well, that'll do it. We haven't got the score, but that'll do it. There she goes.
She was technically perfect. She was aloof. She dared.
Is it, in the long run, a blessing or a curse? At age 14, it's difficult to know. You just do what comes so naturally. Like a child in a fairy tale, Nadia was plucked out of kindergarten by coaches Marta and Bella Coroni, selected to wear the glass slipper of fame and the drudgery that goes with it, both sides of Cinderella. In Romania, the young gymnasts emerge in an almost eerie fashion. tiny dolls, somersaulting forward in time, some to great rewards, other to disappointment tough for a child to take. There are so many. Yet only one Comaneci.
I always thought that I was born with a little talent, something probably a little unusual than the other people, I think. But also I realized that I cannot do it without very, very, very hard work. A lot of people, they have a lot of talent, but probably they're not in the right place in the right time.
The right time and place arrived for Nadia during the 1976 Olympic Games in Montreal. All eyes were focused on the 14-year-old prodigy.
And now here is Nadia Comaneci on the uneven bars.
Chris, this could be the highlight of the compulsory event. She is one of the technically strongest, best gymnasts that I've ever seen. Watch this. Beautiful rhythm, right to a handstand. Oh, look at that amplitude. Ooh. She is really moving well. Another handstand. Look at that, right to the handstand. Gorgeous routine, beautiful, and the crowd loves it.
The performance seemed perfect.
I wouldn't be surprised if she got a 10.
But would the judges agree? No Olympic gymnast had ever been given a perfect score of 10.
And it is
a perfect 10. The first time I have ever seen that in Olympic competition, a perfect 10.
Oh, now they begin to stand here at the forum. This is the first stand competition.
I heard noise. When the score came, when they turned the score to me, there was 1.00. And I think somebody of the my teammates said that I think that's probably a 10.
The score came up. The big wide number one. Now, we didn't know what that means. Number one as rank order, number one as performance, or what that's been. Because nobody ever expected that before, and nobody ever received a perfect 10.
To get a perfect 10 at the Olympics was unheard of.
The most coveted title, the all-around championship. Nadia's perfect scores were the biggest story of the Olympic Games. She had captured the headlines and stolen our hearts.
If Nadia had gotten a 999999, it wouldn't have turned heads. But because she got that perfect score, it changed everything. And people who had never heard of her before, people who had barely ever heard of gymnastics before, and to some extent I count myself in that group, suddenly had an interest in her.
The New York Times, as Augusta Journal as that, decided to put Nadia on page one in their coverage of the Olympic Games.
Nadia also became the first gymnast to have her own song. Originally scored for a movie, this music, used during ABC's replays of Nadia's performances, became so popular it was re-released after the games. With a new title, Nadia's Theme, it too went gold, selling over 1 million copies. It is impossible to hear this without picturing the youngster with the ponytail who would inspire so many others.
I idolized Nadia Comaneci. I remember watching 76, and I said, Mommy, I said, I'm going to be in the Olympics. And she patted me on the head and said, sure, honey, sure.
I wanted to be perfect. I used to walk by every single fountain that you threw a coin in to make a wish. And I'd throw the coin in, and I'd say, I hope to be the greatest gymnast ever in the history of gymnastics. That's a pretty big wish, but it came from seeing Nadia, because I think that's what she became.
Nadia was perfectly cast in her own fairy tale where any dream could come true, but there was no certainty of a happy ending. Her story would have its villain too. Nicolae Ceaușescu, the Romanian dictator, would trade on the avalanche of attention focused on his country's brightest star.
Being famous was not exactly a good thing for me. Even that I thought that probably this is going to help me in my life, I think that this really, really destroyed my life at that particular time.
Hidden so long behind the Iron Curtain, Romania is still a mysterious place to most of us. After surviving a violent revolution, it is a country in transition, struggling to gain a place in the modern world. Yet many of its citizens remain tied to the ways of their ancestors. There is comfort in tradition that gives identity to a people who, for decades, suffered under the harshest and most tyrannical regime in the communist bloc. Nestled at the top of the Balkan Peninsula, Romania shares a border with the former Soviet Union. Imprisoned by geography, this tiny nation was crushed by the Russians under the leadership of Joseph Stalin at the end of World War II. Ironically, the dictator most likened to the notorious Stalin was Romania's Nicolae Ceaușescu. After seizing power in 1967, he imposed his own reign of terror, suppressing a nation yearning to come of age. This is Revolutionary Square in the heart of Bucharest, Romania. It was here that the most violent and bloody revolution of all those sweeping Eastern Europe in 1989 gathered momentum. And it was from this balcony that Romanian dictator Nicolae Ceaușescu was to deliver the final speech of his life, enraging a public so weary and abused, they were willing to risk anything to bring him down. Hello, I'm Donna Deverona. Today, ABC Sports joins Romania's first citizen, Nadia Comaneci, as she returns home by special invitation after defecting from this country 5 years ago before the revolution. For 20 years, ABC Sports has documented her career. Today, we join her as she relives her life under the Ceaușescu regime, an environment where paranoia and fear were her constant companions. After the 1976 Olympics, Nadia came home to a hero's welcome. She was given the Romanian Communist Party's highest honor by President Ceaușescu. It was cause for celebration in a country that had little to cheer about.
I think there was an overall excitement and joy. I mean, it was one of the very few things which could actually enlighten the hearts of Romanians. And that was something that resounded in every Romanian soul.
For Nicolae Ceaușescu, Nadia was invaluable property of the state and his best tool for propaganda.
Ceaușescu did realize the potential which is hiding behind these popularity of gymnastic and personally of Nadia, and very soon started to use that intensively and drastically.
From behind the walls of his presidential palace, Ceaușescu conspired to control every aspect of Romanian gymnastics. In 1977, after a scoring controversy, he pulled the team out of the European Championships, costing Nadia the title. When Bella Caroli protested this action, Ceaușescu removed him as Nadia's coach. She was devastated.
Somewhere at the high level, somebody thought that Bella is not a Romanian, and he's got Hungarian nationality, and maybe it's not good for the intern politics, you know. I end up having to change the coach, and I didn't know why, but what am I going to do? He was just a little bit confused for us. I didn't know what's happening. When we get an order to do and move to some place, we just move. We don't ask anybody why, because even if we ask, they're going to say, it's not your business.
The loss of Caroli would not be the only heartbreak for the teenager. That same year, her parents divorced. Nadia felt alone and undirected. By 1978, with her training disrupted, clearly out of shape, and exhausted by a grueling schedule of government-ordered appearances, Nadia faked a suicide attempt. Her balance was gone, both personally and professionally. It was a cry for help.
I wasn't thinking so good probably at that time. I didn't know what I wanted. It was just that time when you just go up, 16, 17, you know, you don't know what to do. Things change in your perspective. You're not sure where you want to go, what direction. Everything is getting confused.
Is this the child who charmed a billion people? Is this the fragile Nadia Comaneci, heroine of Montreal? It is, but 2 years and more later, 20 pounds heavier, and much, much older.
Or she's doing exactly the same routine she did. Oops, oh. A fall! That completely knocks her out.
Nadia Comaneci completely coming apart on the uneven bars where she thrilled the world in Montreal.
You can see there's a little bit
of... It was the first time that we saw Nadia fall. And you felt very badly. You know, it was like this champion who was crumbling before your eyes, and it was devastating. You didn't want to see the sport do this to her. And when she fell, you know, it was as if, I'm sure, she felt she'd let everybody down. And it was probably the lowest point in her career.
Sure, a gold MasterCard has at least a $5.
Success and unwilling to accept a life of anonymity in Romania, Nadia reunited with Bella Caroli to stage a comeback that would stun the gymnastics world.
It was very hard for me to come back. I thought that it's going to be the ending of... I'm going to somehow just disappear from gymnastics. And, it was something inside that told me, you can do it. You've got to try.
Because she had come from the pit, emotionally and career-wise, it was an even greater triumph, and that was really exciting.
We will never know all of the causes to Nadia's problems early on. The most important thing about all those problems is the fact that she overcame them. Not only within her gymnastics career, because she did. She came back as strong as ever in 1979. I saw it with my own eyes.
Many believe that 1979 was Nadia's greatest year of gymnastics competition. Once again lean and powerful, she won her third all-around title at the European Championships. At the World Cup in Tokyo, she took first place in the uneven bars and balance beam, along with the all-around title. Capping a year of glory at the Moscow Games in 1980, Nadia won the gold in the floor exercise, balance beam, and only after a 28-minute scoring controversy, narrowly missed the gold in the all-around. In her career, Nadia won a total of 9 Olympic medals, 5 of them gold. She accomplished what few in the sport have been able to do, compete as a mature woman and win. Finding focus and trust again, the combination of Bella and Nadia was magic. But barely 6 months after her Olympic victories, at the end of a tour in the United States with a Romanian team, Caroli defected. Shocked by his disappearance, she made a desperate attempt to find him.
I tried to get his room key and to see what happened if he's in the room. And it was hard to get his room key because the housekeeping didn't want to give me the room key. And I said, I forgot something in that room, and please let me in because I have something that I have to get out. So she opened the door, and when she opened the door, it was empty. And then it was like a shock for me, just something that cut my knees down. I realized that I think he's not going to come back.
We started to realize we're still just simple tools in the hand of the government. We do not have, and we cannot have, our own opinion. We cannot keep our own integrity. We cannot express ourselves. Then became very frustrating, and later almost unbearable to live in the same type of, in the society, where you are simple, only just a tool, only just a toy in the hand of the government.
Just before the 1984 Olympics, Nadia's life would change quickly, from the extraordinary to the ordinary. when she ended her competitive career at an emotional farewell exhibition in Bucharest. ABC's Chris Schenkel was there.
Capacity crowd in love with Nadia Comaneci. We had lumps in her throat. I have one now. Because you knew that was the last time Nadia was going to get on the beam and do as well as we had seen her do. And it was just the end of a competitive career for this lovely young woman.
Unlike other communist sports systems, Romania's was neither generous nor benevolent. There would be few privileges after gymnastics and only fool's gold at the end of her rainbow.
I always dream about things that happened to me after I did things, but they were just dreams. You know, I hoped and hoped and hoped, and things didn't happen that way.
10 years ago, when Nadia said farewell to her sport and stopped winning gold medals, she began to realize the Ceausescu regime's use for her had changed. And that's when she began to dream of freedom. In 1984, Ceausescu defied a Soviet-led boycott, entering Romania in the Los Angeles Olympics.
A standing ovation for 88,000 for Romania, which spoke its own mind by coming to the Games despite the boycott by the Soviet and their other allies.
It was a calculated move to camouflage human rights abuses at home and gain favor with the West. Sent as an ambassador of goodwill, Nadia was closely watched for fear she might defect. It was the last time she was allowed to travel to a non-communist country.
I remember her very distinctly, and I could not help but thinking, if she were in any other enterprise in her life, if she was 22, 23 years old, her life would be beginning. But she was used up and thrown away, and there was something very depressing about that.
She returned home to a life of limitations. Her travel restricted by the state and her coaching skills confined to a junior team, Nadia grew increasingly restless.
The thing that frustrated me was that nobody was giving me any explanation why I'm not allowed to go anywhere and why everybody was going but me. And I never had the answers, and I knew that I could never get answers from anybody why I'm not going.
Why do you think it was, now that you've...
I think somebody out there hated me. Because I was too famous. Which ended up that being famous was not exactly a good thing for me.
Nadia's celebrity could not protect her from the system into which she was born. Her mail was confiscated and she was placed under surveillance. She earned less than $5,000 in her career, and what little she had was mostly window dressing.
Everybody sees that this is a pretty nice house, but nobody knew that I was sleeping with all my family in the kitchen downstairs because I didn't afford to heat all the house. So it was a nice, beautiful house, but I didn't live in that because it was so cold that I couldn't sleep here. I was ashamed of people to find out that I don't have money.
What are the circumstances that led up to your defection?
The way that the system was, when somebody was too famous here more than two other people, then... they have to be pushed down.
Are you talking about Ceausescu and his son, Nicu?
I'm never comfortable to say the name.
Nicu Ceausescu, the dictator's son, was one of those who had control over Nadia's life. He could be a dangerous man to refuse. Often required to make public appearances with him, there were rumors of a romance.
No, he didn't date me. I think that because I was a well-known person, probably he liked people to see him being involved or, you know, go to a meeting or present me, this is Nadia, the Olympic champion, and for the accomplishments that I did. And everybody starts to rumor thing about that. And, but they were not the way that the people thought about it.
In November of 1989, with communism crumbling in Eastern Europe, Ceausescu re-elected himself for 5 more years. It seemed there would be no end to his madness and no way out for Nadia.
I was afraid, more than anybody else, because I didn't know if that particular time if I'm followed or if I have microphones in my house, which I probably have now too. I'm not sure. I was afraid everybody is terrorized. You live in a communist system. You're terrorized. You don't know if you go out of the door. If it's okay if you go out with the right foot or with the left foot. You don't know what is right and what is wrong. So of course you're afraid.
Coming up, the dramatic story of Nadia's escape from Ceausescu's Romania.
The most outspoken gesture she ever made was to defect from the country. That was the point where Nadia showed herself to the Romanian public in a different light. I mean, as a person who couldn't take it anymore.
Shake it. No.
And when we separated, I felt an emptiness in my soul. I thought we would never see each other again.
He knew that it's going to be a lot of pressure for them. It's going to be police and everything. Everybody's going to come to the house. And I told him, you realize that it's going to be a big disaster for anybody here if I'm going to leave. And he said, don't worry about us. We're going to take care of us. Yeah, he said, just go ahead and do your thing and just call us to see if you made it okay.
The next day, Nadia and seven other Romanian nationals began their dash for freedom. They boarded a train in the center of Bucharest, the first step on a long and dangerous race to neighboring Hungary, where they hoped to be given asylum. The train carrying the refugees made its way west to Timișoara. Within 2 weeks, Romania's revolution would ignite in this village. From there, it would be an all-night trek across open fields to the border.
It was very confusing for me at that time. I don't think I was realizing what I was doing. It was very confusing, but I was just going, you know. I just didn't want to stop, so I think I was very lucky I made it.
Why is that?
Because I could have get caught.
What do you think would have happened to you if you got caught?
I don't want to think about it.
With the help of the U.S. Embassy, Nadia arrived in New York 3 suspenseful days later. With Constantine Panit, a Romanian border runner who had helped her escape, the press descended on them. Meanwhile, in Romania, dictator Nicolae Ceausescu, embarrassed by the defection of a national hero, ordered his Securitate police to Nadia's home. They sealed off the door to her trophy room. Nadia's family was arrested and interrogated. Her sister-in-law suffered a miscarriage. The fate of every family member was in jeopardy.
I was arrested by the Securitate and questioned from morning till night for 3 weeks. Hours and hours with no food, just water. Luckily, the revolution saved us. Only after it did I discover that Elena Ceausescu had personally ordered the elimination of the Comaneci family.
Nadia's family was saved by the revolution. Many other Romanians did not survive the liberation of their country. In what was once a children's park, the names of those who gave their lives to bring down this regime are enshrined on monuments to their courage and sacrifice. famous rule of Ceausescu will not be forgotten, nor will the image of the dictator executed on Christmas Day lying on the cold ground of a free nation.
For the Romanian people and for Nadia, to understand the parameters of freedom in the West and all that comes with living in a free country. Once again, here's Donna Deverona.
Welcome to America!
Nadia's welcome to America was short-lived. Attention quickly shifted to the man at her side. Konstantin Panit had helped her escape a few days after they met at a party in Romania.
This is my friend who helped me to come here. And I want to thank him.
It was revealed that her new friend was a married father of four. Nadia was portrayed as a homewrecker. She was once again the captive of a man who sought to profit from her fame at the expense of her image.
I didn't like that the people were starting to write things about me that they were not truth. I haven't had a chance to talk with anybody because I've been controlled. Everything was controlled by him. There was a time when I thought, here I am in a free country, and I still cannot do what I want to do.
Did he ever hit you?
He was not very nice to me. That's all I can say about that. I was afraid that somebody's going to send me home. You know, I was still under that system and power and afraid of anything. I didn't know what to do. But somewhere behind my brain, it was a little door that gave me a little light that probably I can find somebody to help me to get out of, you know, this nightmare that
was to get ready for the World Gymnastics Championships, and as soon as I walked into the apartment, the phone was ringing, and I never heard her so terrorized in my life.
It was another starting from zero for me, because I didn't know where to go, what to do.
I said, come to Oklahoma. Why don't you come here, and I'll take care of you, and you can be with me, and we'll work it out. And from that moment on, she was in my life every day.
History placed Nadia on the world stage at a very young age, drove her from her homeland, and brought her here to the southern Great Plains of Norman, Oklahoma. And through it all, gymnastics has been the tie that binds Nadia to her past, to her future, and the man she loves, Bart Conner.
I pretty much trust him from the beginning, and then I started to trust him more, but there was nothing suspicious about him because I realize that he doesn't want anything from me.
What began as a friendship blossomed into a romance. Bart and Nadia are now engaged to be married. They are also partners in a myriad of business enterprises, including his gymnastics academy in Norman. Her life in America has shown us a side of Nadia we've never seen before.
I think, unfortunately, when we first saw Nadia, we saw a cold, hard, maybe not flattering, but a rather unattractive Nadia. And this is how she became as a result of her environment. And since she's been in the States, she's been able to chip away at that harder shell. And now you see, and I saw it a long time ago. I saw it before my friends knew it. My friends are like, what are you doing with that girl? And even my family was a little suspicious, you know. And I said, you know, there are some brilliant things about this young lady, and the world's going to see it someday. She's smart, she's interesting, she's unique, she's got character.
I love with passion, and I don't play games with. I even do it or not. So I don't. You know, he was a little, you know. I'm not sure if I. This is what I had to teach him.
These two athletes coming from such different worlds would now almost seem incomplete without each other.
Everything he does, I like. And I like that I learned a lot of things from him. And he always told me, you have to trust me, and you have to trust me because, you know, that's what everything is built around.
She was loved because of her perfect tens, and she was loved because she could make money for somebody. But I wanted her to know that she was loved because just who she is. Even now, there's a lot of secrets. There's a lot of things she will never tell me, I'm sure. She has to know that no matter what she says to me, it's not going to shake the foundation of what we have.
Coming up, Nadia takes Bart home to Romania for an unforgettable journey into her past. How much has her country really changed, and what has become of her friends and her family in the 5 years she has been gone?
That's one.
Perfectly, to coincide with the World Team Gymnastics Championships in Dortmund, Germany. A sponsor of the Romanian national team, Nadia has donated $100,000 to help support them through the Olympic Games in Atlanta.
I was thinking a couple of years ago, what can I do? How can I be involved doing something for the Romanian Gymnastics Federation and also for the girls? Because we've been so close friends, and I know that they don't have a very, very easy life. And I wanted to do something for them, for what they did for me, and just, you know, help the program because they deserve to be helped.
Her investment is already reaping rewards. There might just be another Nadia on this team. On her last event in the competition, Lavinia Milosevic clinched the team championship. It was the first time Romania had been on top of the victory stand since Nadia led her team to the world title in 1979. They are out to prove that gymnastics is still Romania's number one export. Then they were all off to Bucharest together, with lots of reasons to celebrate. Newspaper headlines announced the return of Nadia, the queen of gymnastics, and her engagement to Bart Connor. But even with all this attention, Nadia was apprehensive as she first set foot on Romanian soil in Timișoara. 5 years ago, she might have been captured here. This time, so many fans came to see her, she was asked to get off the plane to greet them. It was an unplanned moment that gave her a sense of what was to come. Nadia's dreams of being home again had finally come true. She was here by special invitation of the government, but she couldn't have imagined the scene waiting for her at the airport. Among the crowds and journalists, her mother, Steffi, was jostled by the hundreds of Romanians who had come to see and to touch and to talk to Nadia. It was sheer chaos. If Nadia had any fear she'd been forgotten, it was gone. Children not yet born when Nadia won gold chanted her name. In the arms of her friends and family, she began to feel the embrace of an entire nation. On this whirlwind tour, there was a need to know everything about Nadia. After all, there were 5 years of questions waiting to be asked. It was also a chance for Nadia to show Bart her Romania. They crisscrossed the country mainly by motorcade, meeting officials and dignitaries. Treated like a royal couple on a state visit, they met with the Minister of Sport and were official guests of Romania's Prime Minister. There were also places that brought back memories of darker times. The House of the Republic is rarely open to visitors. Nicolae Ceaușescu destroyed the most beautiful section of Bucharest to make way for a presidential palace that would rival Versailles. While Romanians went cold and hungry, Ceausescu poured $1 billion into this still unfinished and empty structure. It looms over the city as a painful reminder of the system gone terribly wrong. The shadows of the past were lifted by a new generation of youngsters who welcomed Nadia and Bart with an outpouring of affection. Diva, the site of the Olympic Training Center, where Nadia prepared for the 1980 Olympics, was the setting for a nostalgic reception. The students surprised her with a song in English.
Dar acum eu învăț românește. Cu profesor Mama Nadia. Mulțumesc, vă doresc mult noroc și sănătate.
The highest official reception was given by Romanian President Iliescu, who congratulated the gold medal gymnastics team. In a country that has known such adversity, they are a great source of pride, and it all began with Nadia.
Could you please try in English to say what it means to have Nadia return to Romania?
I think it is a general satisfaction for all the Romanians, because Nadia has remained in our heart. She was the first performer of the national gymnastics, and she remained the memory of all the Romanians.
President Iliescu was so proud, he invited Nadia and Bart to hold their wedding in the palace. Coming up, the moment Nadia has been waiting for. She returns to her birthplace and reunites with the father she thought she might never see again.
Proper etiquette begins at...
The final stop of Nadia's journey would be the place she was born and where her father still lives. The village of Onești. The sound of the motorcade was an odd intrusion in this rural setting, signaling the arrival of a woman who brought honor and joy to this beleaguered country.
From Timișoara to Bucharest to her home in Onești, people have traveled more than 50 miles, crowding the streets to catch a glimpse of Romania's most famous citizen. Word is spread that Nadia is coming home.
The trip from Bucharest to Onești usually takes 3 hours. On this day, it took 6. The drive constantly interrupted by throngs of people who came to see Nadia. Her presence had a magical effect, as though she was a Pied Piper playing an irresistible tune. Children who had never seen her compete knew the stories. She was part of their folklore.
I've only seen her on TV. We are very happy she came back to Romania.
I cried when I saw her. I came from 50 miles away for this sweet girl. She is the pride of our country.
It's a great joy to see her return with such honors after so many years.
Nadia was relieved to find that most Romanians never felt she had betrayed them, but saw her defection as a statement of independence.
I think she's the most appropriate ambassador of our country. When she left, she expressed the wishes of our people. If someone else had done it, it would not have had such an impact.
I'm very excited nowadays here. She has brought us only victories. I missed her and felt a sadness when she left. We loved her so much.
In this new Romania, the demonstrations of emotion were like nothing she had ever experienced before. Nadia was cherished as a symbol of their own hard-won freedom. November 23, 1994, was declared Nadia Comaneci Day in Onești. Everyone was given the day off. Nadia's father, Gheorghe, still lives in the same apartment house where Nadia grew up. She hadn't seen him in over 5 years. Nadia hasn't forgotten. It was from her father she learned the toughness that has carried her through life.
Her father and stepmother extended Bart a traditional Romanian greeting. And being the perfect gentleman that he is, in carefully practiced Romanian, Bart asked for Nadia's hand in marriage. And Jorge gave his blessing. Just a few blocks from her home, Nadia found her first love, gymnastics. She was only 6 years old when she left her family and eagerly went off to live full-time in this experimental boarding school. Here, academics were combined with intensive training in her sport. Earmarked early on as championship material, much was expected from this little girl with a somber expression.
Nadia, open that up.
But even a child with exceptional gifts would find time for mischief and play. Her teammates had become her family. These tiny girls shared big dreams in one small room. Nadia's old room was still waiting for her.
This is the room where I used to sleep. Mm-hmm. But the bed are not the same. They, after 76, so they renovated everything. I think with the money that was supposed to be mine. the beds were a lot smaller at that time. And probably because we jump a lot on them, we kind of destroy them.
Was that like a trampoline for the
kids? Yeah, there was. It is like a trampoline, I think.
Still works. So,
yeah, it still works.
And Nadia was thrilled to find that one of her former teachers was still there.
She's going to show me my class. And the kids that they stay up, they are after me and they're taking class here.
The children performed an ancient Romanian chant of goodwill. Nadia had risen to fulfill her promise to her hometown. It was their turn to complete the circle, and in renaming their school after her, they forever claimed her as their own. The most unexpected gift was the gathering of the members of her 1976 Olympic team. They traveled from all over Romania to see her. When Nadia made sports history, these women were part of it. The years and distance had not diminished the bond of friendship which had begun in this gymnastics school in Onești. This day was as memorable as any Olympic victory.
There was something in my heart about this trip that I hope that everything is going to be okay and it's going to take a stone from my heart, but it really did. I have nothing back on my brain that I have to accomplish or I have to do something to be thankful or to meet the people that I left behind and just talk with them or apologize, or I didn't know what to do at the time when I arrived here. So I think my life is going to be really complete after that. So I have no plans after this.
Nadia had proven that you can go home again. Saying goodbye is always difficult, but this time was different. She knew it didn't mean forever. Coming up, Nadia performs for the first time in her homeland in 10 years.
Start a project.
Since Nadia's farewell, the palace's fort has not been used for gymnastics, but the arena promises to come alive once again to a sold-out crowd as Nadia performs on the five-year anniversary of her defection. Certainly, the crowds never expected to see Nadia perform again. Romanian tradition dictates that once an athlete retires, her performing days are over. But breaking with tradition is nothing new for Nadia. This was simply another challenge to be met.
Nervous?
Yeah, a little.
Like a prize fighter about to step into the ring, Nadia prepared for one of her greatest tests. Would she live up to the expectations of the crowd? At 32, would her performance be received as warmly by her countrymen as it was when she was a 14-year-old darling of her sport? She was competing with memories. It took courage to come back and take center stage, but it was a fitting conclusion to a homecoming she would never forget. Coming up, some final thoughts from Nadia.
Nadia.
Thank you. I'm very touched and I'm very happy. I didn't realize that my trip would be so beautiful, although I knew I had a lot of friends. I'm happy that you didn't forget me, and I assure you that although I live far away from this country, I will never forget that I am Romanian. Bart knows this very well. I will always come home with pleasure, and I will forever be at the side of the Romanian Gymnastic Federation and our gymnasts who will represent us at the next Olympiad in America. I wish all of you many years of good health and a lot of joy. Thank you.
The name of Nadia Comaneci in gymnastics will always be intertwined. While others made mistakes, Nadia made none. She showed us perfection was possible. Whatever her sacrifices, her ambition drove her to want more.
To accomplish those kind of results, that I wanted to do it, because at the end I'm going to say, yes, I accomplished something in my life. I didn't just pass my life like anybody else. And later I'm just going to be a worker in a factory. I didn't want to be like that.
She was the greatest physical talent ever in the field of the women's gymnastics. A strong,
almost unstoppable competitive machine, which was rolling over her adversaries.
When she had to do it under what I would call miserable conditions compared to our life here in the United States, that took a spirit, that took grit that very few of us have.
I think there's a fighter inside, and I think in Nadia's case there's an extra spark, there's a little mischief, there's a little smile in there, and a determination to continue, just to keep going.
No one has done what Nadia's done since. There's been a lot of gold medals won, a lot of perfect tens scored, but no one has touched what Nadia did 20 years ago.
The young woman who stepped off the plane in Romania last fall is not the same person who fled 5 years ago. She was willing to risk all that she loved to leave a world we may never comprehend. When Nadia came to America, she left everything behind. In returning to Romania, she put back the pieces of her life that might have been lost forever. Perhaps her greatest accomplishment is that she has survived. The courage to go home again, she discovered the people of Romania will always think of her as theirs.
It's very important to be back now and find out what exactly the people thought about me, if they love me, if they thought that I did a good job, if I represent the country okay, if they are proud of me and they think that they want.
So you're a lot of peace now?
Yeah, I am.
And is the pain over those other things?
I have no pain. Just in the morning when I woke up, I'm a little hurt here on my back. I'm getting old.
It's the compelling stories of athletes like Nadia Comaneci that over three decades have been the cornerstone of Wide World of Sports.